Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn, and in this tutorial, we're going to look at rigging the arm. To begin with, the assets you'll need is a drawing of an arm. We're going to, first of all, break down this into the character pieces so you can create the puppet with the articulations. To break down the character, the artist cuts parts such as the hands and arms from the character's model and pastes them into separate layers. I'll show you how to create the ball joints for each of the pieces before we start the rigging process. First of all, select the hand, copy and cut, paste it into a new drawing layer, which you'll name hand. Arrange the drawings in the node view. Paste the copied hand into the new hand layer. Select the drawing layer for the rest of the arm. Using the cutter tool, select where the elbow articulation would be. Create a new drawing layer called upper arm, then paste that piece into the upper arm layer. You may want to rearrange the order of the drawing nodes and then rename the remaining drawing to lower arm. On the first drawing, you may need to uncheck animate using animation tools. You can then use the preset ellipse, hold down shift to constrain proportions, use the select tool just to nudge it and shift it into place. Select the underlayout layer and put in the rotation point. Hold down shift just to select between the points and delete, and using the contour editor, snap the contour, close the gaps. You may want to use just one bezier handle, so you can hold down option to control one handle at a time, just making sure you smooth out that curve. You can repeat the process for the lower arm, using the ellipse tool to draw the circle, then using the select tool to position and scale. Don't forget to put in the rotation point in the underlayout layer, and then hold down shift to select between the points and delete. Use the snap to contour to close any gaps and to snap the points together, using the contour editor to smooth out any lumps that you may have in the ball joint, and repeat the process for the top of the lower arm. With any lines that are overlapping, you can select the line using the contour editor, hold down Command to make an additional point, and then delete whatever is overlapping. This is so that you don't get a double thickness on the line. If you have varying thicknesses on the line, you can select the pencil editor by hitting the shortcut 8. You can then delete the points by selecting the red dots, add a rounded end and start point, and then move the line so that they match in thickness. You can show the stroke by hitting the shortcut K just to see if there are any gaps in your line, which can be seen with the yellow dots. Using snap to contour, just make sure that the lines are snapped together. And you'll need this before you can add any color fill using the paint tool. When you're adding color, select on the line art layer and select the option for make color art from line art. You then select the color art layer and drop in the color using the paint tool, making sure that all the lines are closed in the stroke. For the rigging process, select all your drawing nodes and put in multiple pegs. And remember, we put in the rotation point in our underlay art layer. We want to be able to display that by getting the underlay node and attaching it firstly to the hand so it reveals the rotation point. This is just so that you can get accuracy as to where to put your rotation point in. Remember to drag the rotation point from the center, from the pivot point, and not the arrow. Once you've placed the rotation point, you can use the transform tool to pose the hand just to check that it's not jutting out or in an awkward position in relation to the lower arm. You can then disconnect the underlay layer from the hand and reconnect it to the lower arm to reveal the lower arm's rotation point that you put in the underlay art layer. Place the rotation point and test it using the transform tool. It's important to make sure that the rotation point of the elbow will be in a position that doesn't jut out Go ahead and do the same with the upper arm and place a rotation point. Once you're finished, we want to place the peg hierarchy. So the upper arm is the parent of the lower arm, and the lower arm is the parent of the hand. So just drag your connectors to connect each step of the peg. And then test it using the transform tool. The upper arm, when you select it, will select the whole hierarchy, but you can move all the other pegs independently. You won't need the underlay layer now, it's done its job, so you can delete it. But you will need an auto patch to patch the line art so that we have the color art as a seamless piece that runs all the way through. The auto patch connector is always placed above the piece that you want to patch to. So in the case of the lower arm, we connect the auto patch and make sure the connector is above the hand. Once this is done, you can test it using the transform tool and pose your arm. You can reset at any time by selecting the pieces and hitting R to reset. Now we can test the rig and make a little animation of an arm pointing. Make sure all your layers are collapsed by hitting O. Put in a keyframe. You should see a red dot. Move it to the next frame. On around frame 9, let's break the joint and pose the arm. We can delay the hand a little bit. On around frame 16, let's add another keyframe. Let's pose it in the breakdown position, which is also an extreme keyframe. So the arm goes all the way up and is going to anticipate for the final action. So again, we're going to delay the hand. Select on the top peg, which is the master peg. We're going to do another breakdown position on around keyframe 21, so it exaggerates the pose even more. On frame 31, we can start going to the final pose, but we want to anticipate the settle position. We're going to create a slight overshoot. Once we've got to the final pose, let's make another keyframe and then go back to the previous keyframe to add a little stretch before we finish the final pose. Add the motion keyframes by selecting all and then selecting motion keyframes on. We can test the animation. You can also add drawing substitutions for the hand, so you've got different hands as the hand rises and points. When you're making a drawing substitution, it's the same process as paperless animation. Onion skin on, draw each hand on top of the other. When you're making your selections, use the bracket keys at the points where the hand changes position. And that's it for a basic arm rig and keyframe animation. See you next time.